Hello and welcome to an MSC APEX feature update. This update is focused on the addition of native support for Advanced Nonlinear, also known as Solution 400, which was added in the 2021.4 release. I think the best way to illustrate what has been added is to run through a short example highlighting the capability that's been added into MSC APEX. The example we have, we're going to model the interaction between this indenter and the roof panel of this car, looking at the extent of plastic strain as the indenter presses into it, but also looking at the force displacement characteristics of the indenter as it moves forward. So we need to add some extra information into the model in order to support this type of analysis. So firstly, we need to define the material to add the stress strain behavior, so a plasticity model. We need to define the interaction between the indenter and the roof panel, and we need to apply the enforced displacement boundary condition. So let's get started. So under the steel model, we have a number of constitutive models, and we're going to add to that plasticity. So we're going to use a stress strain curve. So we go in here to define it. Now we could type the values in, but I have it already entered into a comma separated values file. And you can see what we've imported is the set of pairs of strain stress starting at 0, 0. And these are true strain, true stress, rather than engineering strain, engineering stress values. So hit apply, and that's our material model updated with the plasticity model. So the next thing we need to do is define the contact between these two parts. So we do that as an interaction, and it's a general interaction between that part and that part, and that gets added into the model tree here under interactions to see that we've got an interaction between those two parts. The next thing we need to do is to define the enforced displacement boundary condition to push this down 25 millimeters. So the first thing I'm going to do is create a discrete tie of the rigid type that basically connects those nodes there to that node there. And then under loads, I'm going to do an enforced motion, and I'm going to apply it directly. And I want to not just enforce the motion in the Z downward direction by 25 millimeters, but I want to make sure that I've enforced a zero motion on the other 5 degrees of freedom. Otherwise, the thing will spin, or the problem will become statically indeterminate. So then I just apply that to the point there, and we're ready to go into job setup. So we move over into studies, and we can delete the static linear static scenario because we don't need it, and we can create a new scenario where the type is nonlinear. We only want one load case, so it's okay. And then we just work our way down, configuring as we go. So for the model representation, we're going to use all of the model. The loads and boundary conditions, we're going to choose to apply our enforced displacement and choose the existing constraints. Simulation settings, we want to make sure we turn on large displacement so that our buckling behavior is accurate. And then on the static step, I'm going to go and I'm going to use the advanced stepping to turn on the adaptive incrementation. I'm going to turn on the automatic quasi-static inertial damping. And then when I go into iteration and convergence, I'm going to force it to go through two cycles per iteration just to ensure convergence. It's already set up to output nonlinear stress and strains. So we've got all the output we need, so we're in fact ready to go. So I'm going to export this. I'm going to call it indent 01. And I'm going to make sure the units are set to millimeter, ton, second, Kelvin. It is. I hit apply. And then I will run this job and we'll import the results afterwards. So I will just set this off to run now. Okay, so the analysis has run and we're ready to import the results. So I go back up here to the scenario and I import the Nastran results. make sure the units are consistent, browse to pick up the H5 file and hit import. So we can go into the post processor here. And you can see we have all the steps of the output as it's an incremental load addition. And if we go to the very last one, look at the von Mises stress, we can see the stress pattern there from the indenter having pressed in. And then we can go and we can modify that to look at the nonlinear strain so that we can see where there is effective plastic strain building up, so non-recoverable deformation. So you can see we have a high level there and some more developing there. The last thing we wanted to look at was the force displacement characteristics. So I go in here to add an XY display, and then I'm just going to zoom in on the node where we applied the force displacement. I'm just going to pick up that point. That's the thing I'm going to plot for, and then I can go down here to force displacement curve. So you can see we have an initial deformation with no force, no reaction force, which is taking up the gap between the indenter and the roof panel. And you can see as the indenter advances, the force increases. So we could take off from this if the applied force was due to be 400 newtons, we can pick up the fact that the overall deformation would be about 22.5 millimeters. So we know at what point to recover the actual results. Okay, so that's just a quick run through overview of how you can interact with Advanced Nonlinear Solution 400 from within MSC APEX. Thank you.